Good morning, Bulldogs. Well, today we are at the end of yet another week, and we are going to dig into the Greek and Latin roots. So you're probably thinking to yourself, we're not in Greece. We're not in a Latin country. Why do I care? Well, the reason being, knowing some of these roots helps us to be able to understand the meaning of words that we use today. As a matter of fact, most of our words have roots in another language. So we're going to look at a couple of different roots today, and I've actually included a YouTube video that has a wrap for a few of the more common roots. Now, we don't have time in all of seventh grade for you to learn and understand all the Greek and Latin roots, so we're going to focus on just a few. You have your notes. I've actually sent over, I've uploaded a copy of, I believe it's eight or nine of the most common roots you're going to see. So look at the root chron, C-H-R-O-N. What does that mean? Well, chron is Greek for time. So chronological is an order of time. So if I tell something in chronological order, I'm telling something in order of time, in the order of events. A chronicle is a writing of time, the newspaper. So think of your roots as a way to use clues within the word to understand what it means. Because sometimes we don't always have a dictionary. We don't always have our phone with us to look up a word. And maybe the clues around us in a paragraph or in a conversation, we can't understand what the word means that way. So if you look at the root and the prefixes and suffixes and all the parts that we know about, you can figure out what that word means. Automobile. For example, what's the root in automobile? Well, it's got auto. Auto is another Greek root, and it means self, like self-paced or done by self, self. So an automobile is a self-operating mobile. It's a car. Automobile is a car. Okay, so I want you guys to review the notes that I'm uploading, and it's going to say the root and the meaning of the root, and I have another page that is going to give a root, and then some of the more common words that you're going to hear with that root. Is it going to list every single word in the English language? No, we don't have that kind of space. But for chron, for example, you're going to see chronicle, chronological, chronography. You're going to see some of those words, and just keep that readily available. For my online learners, you're going to save that to the folder that you should have set up last week. Last week, we set up folders for English notes, reading notes, writing notes, and the roots are gonna go in your English notes, okay? So if you guys will do that, your assignment today is going to be creating a three-column notes of sorts for a particular root, and you need to use three words that have that root, tell me what the word means, and then find an image online that represents that word, okay? And I gave you an example so you can see exactly what is expected. Okay. So if you have any questions, just email me over here at aellis@millsapisd.net. Have a great day.